Hi everybody! On 28th of October 2021, Nykaa opened its gates for its initial public offering. And as we all know, the most fascinating thing about Nykaa is that in spite of delivering 17.1 million orders, in spite of operating 80 offline stores in 40 cities, Nykaa has managed to generate a profit of 62 crores in 2021. And this makes Nykaa one of the very few e-commerce companies to actually generate profit. So the question is, how did Nykaa achieve profitability in spite of operating at such a huge scale? What are the strategic advantages Nykaa has over Myntra and Amazon? And most importantly, if you are someone who's looking to invest into beauty and personal care companies in the next 5 years, what are the threats and opportunities that you need to consider before you invest into Nykaa or similar stocks? This video is brought to you by Tickertape Pro, but more on this at the end of the video. The first thing you need to understand is that there are three modes of retail distribution for beauty products in India. The first mode is the unorganized retail, which includes small general stores and drugstores. The second model is the organized retail, which includes exclusive brand outlets and beauty salons. And lastly, we have the online retail model. But the biggest issue with all these models is that, except for a few brand outlets, there are three major problems that customers have been facing in the beauty and personal care sector. Number one, although a huge segment of Indian consumers want to buy beauty products, until now, a major segment of the Indian customers have not been able to access the most reputed brands in the industry. And this lack of accessibility is mostly faced by tier 2 and tier 3 audience. This is the reason why, after the Jio wave, the online BPC market has exploded from a market size of just $206 million in 2017 to $1 billion in 2021. But with the rise of online retail, the second problem came in, and that is duplicate products. Unfortunately, even in the reputed marketplaces like Amazon and Myntra, sellers often sell duplicate makeup products that have drastically affected the online purchase experience of the customers. And third and most importantly, there has been a very big problem of lack of transparency and elaborative information. For example, when it comes to beauty products specifically, you have to be very careful about the ingredients used in the product. And even if it is from a reputed brand, it is important that they do not contain any ingredients that are allergic. But in spite of this thing being a critical problem, Amazon and Myntra both have not been able to address this issue properly. In fact, in the market research that I conducted with the ThinkSchool community, many people even told me that Amazon often sent them expired products, and sometimes the expiry date is purposefully erased or is unreadable. And when this gives them skin allergies, it becomes a terrible experience for the innocent customers. Therefore, transparency and lack of information has been a major problem in the beauty and personal care sector. But this is where, ladies and gentlemen, Nykaa became a game changer. Nykaa not only increased the accessibility through its online presence, but it also understood each one of these problems of the customers. Therefore, they came out with some incredible strategies to become a dominating player in the beauty space. The question is, what are these strategies and how did Nykaa beat the likes of Amazon and Flipkart? Well, the first thing Nykaa did was to opt in for something called the inventory model of e-commerce. For those who know about it, please skip to this timestamp. But for those who don't know, here's a very simple explanation of the same. People, if you look at Amazon or any e-commerce company's operation in India, you will see that they operate with two models. The first model is the marketplace model, and the second model is the inventory model. Marketplace model is the one where there are independent buyers and there are independent sellers. And the e-commerce company merely acts as a platform to connect them through the website or through the mobile application. Whereas, in the inventory model, the company procures products in massive quantities from the sellers at an ultra cheap rate, only to sell it directly to the customers through the mobile app or through the website. To understand this, let's take a very simple example of Amazon and a bookseller. Okay? If a bookseller makes a book at 150 rupees and sells it on Amazon at 450 rupees, in this case, if Amazon acts as a platform, it will generate a revenue of 112 to 150 rupees. And this amount also includes packaging and transportation charges, which leaves them very less scope for profit. But if Amazon operates with the inventory model, then Amazon will buy 10,000 books from the bookseller at once, and then it will use its bargaining power to buy it at just 200 rupees. Then it will keep these 10,000 books in its warehouse eventually to sell it at 450 rupees each on the website. So this way, Amazon can generate 250 rupees in revenue with a little bit of inventory cost. Therefore, they get 100 rupees extra in terms of revenue, even in something as small as books. So when this is done for huge products that cost 10 and 20,000 rupees, the revenue difference skyrockets by $1 billion. Therefore, using the inventory model, the e-commerce companies generate way more profits as compared to the marketplace model. This is the reason why Nykaa opted for the inventory model, wherein Nykaa directly procures the products from Lakmé at bulk and then sells it in its own website by storing it in its inventory. This way, Nykaa generates profits, and at the same time, they've also been able to avoid the duplicate products problem. This is one of the most important reasons why Nykaa has been extremely successful compared to Amazon and Flipkart. Now the question over here is, why can't Amazon and Flipkart do the same? I mean, they're both billion-dollar companies, right? So when a company like Nykaa can do this, why can't these billion-dollar companies use the same strategy? Well, that is because the Indian government brought in new regulations wherein, although the government allows 100% foreign direct investment in the marketplace model of e-commerce, it has not allowed FDI in inventory-driven models of e-commerce. Which means what? From now on, Amazon and Flipkart both cannot use the inventory model. This is the reason why even Cloudtail is shutting down very soon. Whereas in case of Nykaa, since it is an Indian company, they can use the inventory model to sell their products. And this makes Nykaa a very powerful player in the beauty and personal care segment. Now the question is, although Nykaa is a first mover, tomorrow if another Indian company comes up, then what is Nykaa's X factor to survive? Because if not for the X factor, it's going to be another price war like Zomato and Swiggy, right? So the question is, what is the unique value proposition of Nykaa? The answer to this question lies in something called Nykaa's omni-channel approach. To tell you about it, while most companies like Myntra just sell their products, Nykaa believes in building a deeper relationship with its customers by being an integral part of their shopping experience. And they do that in many ways. The first way is by launching something called the Beauty Book, which is Nykaa's in-house magazine. And this magazine doesn't just inform its customers, but educates its customers about their products. For example, Myntra will straight away tell you that here's a bronzing powder that will cost you 2,300 rupees. Whereas, Nykaa's beauty magazine will first teach you how to choose a bronzing powder, and then it will walk you through the best products it has. And one among those products will be a bronzing powder that you can buy at Nykaa for 2,300 rupees. Similarly, if you want to choose the right tone for your foundation, Nykaa has a foundation finder that will ask you about your skin tone, the formulation and the coverage, and then it will give you the best recommendation that you can find at Nykaa. Secondly, Nykaa is building a very powerful community called the Nykaa Network. And in this network, you can go and ask any question related to beauty and personal care. And eventually, you can get it answered from people who have either faced a similar problem or the ones who have found the solution to your problem. And you know what, guys? This strategy has been so successful that this platform, as of 2019, has crossed more than 1 million members. On top of that, they also have 40,000 weekly active users engaging with the brand community. And lastly, they have done an incredible job with content marketing. Nykaa has 1 million subscribers in their YouTube channel, and they also have a team of 3,055 influencers, which include celebrities like Katrina Kaif, trendsetters, fashion bloggers and makeup artists who create content and publish them across several digital platforms. And each one of these content again drives sales through engagement, awareness and endorsement. And to top it all off, Nykaa also has 80 stores in about 40 cities, which also fulfills the touch and feel necessity of the customers, eventually commanding more trust for the brand. And this omni-channel approach, ladies and gentlemen, gives Nykaa three incredible superpowers over the rest of its competition. Number one, considering the fact that online beauty and personal care has only 8% penetration as of 2020, millions of customers will be buying these beauty products online for the first time. And when they do, the most critical factor is going to be the uncertainty of allergy and the lack of knowledge. Therefore, in this case, Nykaa's guiding tools and contents will serve as a critical factor in commanding the trust of the first-time buyers. Secondly, this also leads to an increase in purchase value and very high customer retention. In fact, if you look at the stats, The average order value of a content consumer is 15% higher than a non-content consumer. In addition to that, for customer retention, it has also been observed that the gross merchandise value by existing customers of Nykaa has increased from 59% in FY2019 to 70% in FY21. And lastly, the community posts and interaction gives Nykaa a very big advantage with market research. And most importantly, when they launch their own products, they can use this data to understand the scope of the new product lineups and also focus on important details like allergies and keep track of the changing consumer preferences. And this is all the more a big deal because changing consumer preferences is both the biggest threat and the greatest opportunity in the BPC sector. This is the reason why Nykaa has been super successful and has emerged as the largest e-commerce player in the beauty and personal care sector. So, considering all these factors, it almost looks like Nykaa is on its way to become the most powerful player in the BPC sector, right? So, is it so obvious that you should invest into the company? Well, not really. And this is what brings me to the most important part of the episode, and that is, as investors in the beauty and personal care sector, what are the factors and threats that you need to consider before you invest into Nykaa or similar companies? Before we move on, I want to thank our partners for today's episode, and that is Tickertape Pro. If you haven't started investing yet, the best time is right now. Most people don't know about something called Muhurat Trading. Muhurat is a 1-hour special trading session conducted by the stock exchanges every Diwali. And investing during this session is considered lucky in the Indian investor community. So what are you waiting for, guys? This year on 4th of November, watchlist your favorite stocks on Tickertape, take a look at all the small case links that we've put in the description, and get ready for Muhurat Trading. And Tickertape was also kind enough to make Tickertape Pro free for the month of November for the Think School audience. So if you want to start investing in the auspicious occasion of Diwali, download the Tickertape app from the link in the description. Moving on to the pointers, here are three very, very important factors that you need to consider before you invest into Nykaa or similar companies. Number one, like I said before, the online beauty and personal care has only 8% penetration as of 2020, which means what? 92% of the market is yet to make an online purchase for the first time. So even though Nykaa is a market leader today, if an aggressive Indian player enters the market tomorrow, it wouldn't be too long before that company becomes the largest player again. So the market is far, far away from saturation, which means what? There will definitely be other players in the market very, very soon. So keep your eyes on companies like Purple, which just raised $75 million in funding. And most importantly, keep an eye on Reliance Retail's acquisitions. Number two, customer acquisition is going to be extremely critical for both these players. So it wouldn't be surprising if Nykaa has a few lost quarters. But the point to be noted over here is that your metric of judgment right now should not be profit and loss, but customer acquisition and customer retention strategy of the company. In this case, it was Nykaa's omni-channel strategy. In case of Amazon, it was a sunk cost strategy. So don't be too happy if the company makes a profit. At the same time, don't be too angry if the company incurs losses. And just focus on the metrics that really matter. In this case, it is customer acquisition and customer retention. And lastly, as Nykaa expands, keep talking to the customers because you will get the most valuable insights that no research firm will ever give you. For example, when I was talking to the people in the Think School community, they told me that Nykaa's USP is that it discloses all the ingredients of its products and it also reveals the expiry date, whereas Amazon and Flipkart don't do that properly at all. Similarly, they also told me that Sephora has a way better customer experience at the store as compared to Nykaa, whereas Nykaa has a way better website experience. In fact, every time Parsh has been to a Nykaa store, he somehow has had a terrible experience. So you see, these pointers serve as an important metric that your balance sheets will never tell you. So keep your eyes and ears wide open and be inquisitive about whether Nykaa maintains its consistency of great service or not. And before we say goodbye, I am attaching a few very important research documents for you to read. They contain some of the most amazing insights that I found about the state of e-commerce in India. Along with that, it also contains a document on government regulation, which also, by the way, is an important factor that you need to keep an eye on. So the moral of the story is, before you become fascinated by the company or the hype around it, take some time, investigate with the data, investigate with the people, and then invest your money optimistically but carefully. And I just hope you end up making a lot of money. That's all from my side for today, guys. Wish you a very, very happy Diwali from me and my entire team. Thank you so much for supporting our channel. If you learned something valuable, please make sure to hit the like button in order to make YouTube Baba happy. And for more such insightful business and political case studies, please subscribe to our channel. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye.